All right, guys, we are back in my garage for another video, and you guys have really been enjoying some of these videos I've made recently, getting into the details of different modern BMW engines. So in this video, we're going to continue that and talk about the S68 engine. Now, I know a lot of you think that I'm biased, and you say I think all BMW engines are great, so I only say good things about them. But in reality, that's absolutely not true. I think BMW V8s have a lot of problems, and whether they're naturally aspirated or boosted, they just seem to have too much complexity and too many reliability issues for me to really trust them. However, the more that I've read into what they've done to set up the S68 engine, the more that I feel like this engine is going to be for BMW V8s what the B58 was for BMW inline sixes. It just seems like it's going to completely redefine BMW performance and reliability by taking advantage of all their latest technology without adding too much. Except, of course, for one critical problem. Of course, BMW couldn't get it perfect. But all that and more we're going to talk about in this video, so hopefully you guys find it useful. Now, as always, for everybody that's new to the channel, I create these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in more videos like that, be sure to subscribe because there will be a lot more coming out in the future. So to start this off, let's answer the most popular question I know I'm going to be asked. Which cars have the S68 engine? And when we first started talking about it on the channel was when we saw it getting introduced to the 7 Series and the X7 for the 2023 model year. So if you have a 2023 760i that looks like this, or a 2023 X7 M60i that looks like this, it has the S68 engine, and they also put it in the Alpina version. So if you have an XB7 that looks like this, it also has a version of the S68. Then for the 2024 model year, they also brought it to the 5 Series. So we now have it in the new M5. So if yours looks like this, it has the S68. Also the X5 and X6 M60i versions have the S68. So if your car looks like this, then it has the S68. And also if you have the X5M or X6M competition and it looks like this, then it has the S68 engine. So these are the cars that we have. Oh. Sorry, I forgot once. So if you have an XM, unfortunately, it looks like this. But yes, it also has the S68. Moving right along. So this engine is the new V8 twin turbo engine coming from BMW. It's the same 4.4 liter recipe that a lot of us are used to. It has two turbos, in this case, two twin scroll turbos. So unlike the S58 that has two single scroll turbos, in this case, BMW is taking advantage of having an even number of cylinders on both banks. So now they have four cylinders going to these four runners, and you can see the twin turbo design. So now you not only get twin turbos that can support a lot of power, but you also still get to take advantage of twin scroll technology so that the turbos can spool as quickly as possible. These are also mounted in the valley of the cylinder head, so you'll see it mounted on top of the engine, whereas the intake manifolds are on the sides. And yeah, it's pretty much a design that we're used to by now. Now, the biggest change I think that we're seeing is this is an S-Series engine, and typically that's reserved for M vehicles. So we knew it was probably going to be in the M5, but we didn't expect to see it like in a regular 7 Series or an X5. And this just is changing how things are typically done by BMW. I don't anticipate that there's going to be a B68. That's actually what we expected, but instead they came out with this S68. That uses some of the B58 technology, and that's it. So basically any car that comes with a twin turbo V8 at this point is going to have the S68. And as far as we can tell, pretty much all of the vehicles that are going to get it have already been announced. Now, because of that, it comes with a wide range of horsepower. So we see it as low as 520 horsepower, all the way up to 630 horsepower. So depending on the platform you get it on, you can have an over 100 horsepower spread of how much power it comes with, and it even gets up to over 700 horsepower in the M5 when they pair it with the hybrid technology. So it's definitely a very capable engine. It's gonna come in a lot of different tunes, different amounts of torque. We're seeing it anywhere from 530 to 590 foot-pounds of torque. It really just depends on the vehicle that it's put in and what kind of class or performance they're targeting. Now, another thing they did is increase the compression ratio, which they have been doing over the years as they've done technical updates to the twin turbo V8 engines. Now they are up to 10.5 to 1, so it is a higher compression. So that does improve efficiency and help them meet emissions targets and things like that, and also should help the turbos be more responsive. They also did add diverter valves, so if you look at the turbos, it looks very similar to the ones that we see on the Gen 3 B58 with both an electronic wastegate and an electronic diverter valve. And this does also use the new DME9 architecture. So again, like we've been talking about in the B58 videos, these cars cannot be tuned currently. Your only option would be a piggyback like a JB4 if you were shooting for more horsepower. Now, I see a lot of people saying that the S68 is just an S63 that's been mated to a hybrid system, and it's really pretty much the same thing. But at least in my research, that's not exactly the case. There are a lot of carryover parts, but there also are a lot of unique parts for the S68. So starting off, they changed the internals. All of the internals are new. It has stronger pistons. It also has stronger main bearing caps that should allow it to have a more reliable crankshaft. It also has wider rod bearings, so this will distribute the load more evenly, and it reduces the load on the rod bearings by up to 18%. So just by doing some small redesign to the internals, they're able to help it handle the power better, which should support the reliability we're looking for. Now, on the other hand, when I look at the fuel system, it looks the exact same as the S63. The high pressure fuel pump is the same. The injectors are the same. So if you have any upgrades for the S63 platform, in theory, that should translate over. But again, we don't have any tuning options for these cars, so it's probably not something you can take advantage of yet. Now, the good news is because of the S68 being designed for M cars, it also has better cooling and oil systems, which translates for every car that is going in. So even a regular X5 that has the S68 is going to take advantage of the external oil cooler, the improved lubrication, and the improved oil pickup points. One thing they did mention, though, is that the oil pan is lighter, which when I looked at it, the only difference is they made part of it plastic. So that's not really ideal, but on a vehicle that's probably not going to be that low to the ground, it's probably not a huge risk. I just don't really like seeing plastic parts and extra gaskets and things being needed to put an oil pan together. That seems like a higher opportunity for leaks and cracks and stuff like that in the future. But these cars are still pretty new, so for now, I haven't actually heard of that being an issue. It also has an improved PCV system, which I know has been a big talking point on the B58. So a lot of people were wondering if the S68 has similar issues. It does not look like it's going to have a serviceable valve cover where you can just replace a diaphragm. But the way that it's set up is definitely different because it's going to two different banks. So you have two different cylinder heads with two different valve covers, and both of those ports route back to the intakes. But under low load scenarios, only one of the ports are actually going to be pushing the oil vapors through it. So you're not going to have as much being recirculated through the entire intake system. Only under high load scenarios where you're creating a lot of boost will you actually experience both of them routing the PCV gases back into the intake. So they have a regulator valve that kind of manages that. I don't know how reliable that valve is going to be, but if it is reliable and the way that it's working, it should reduce blow-by, it should reduce carbon buildup, and basically all the things that we don't like about an inefficient PCV system. And if it's anything like the B58, it's probably not going to have a lot of carbon buildup to begin with. Now, even though this was introduced at the same time as the Gen 3 B58, there are a lot of big things that are missing. One is port injection, and I think a lot of that is just kind of packaging. There's no real clean way to add port injection to the S68 since the intake is on the side of the engine. So it's not really a similar intake manifold setup like what we see on the B58. The intercoolers are completely separate from the intake manifold, and the intake manifolds themselves are already really small. There just doesn't seem to be a lot of space down that low in the engine where they could put a big manifold and port injectors and fuel lines and stuff like that. So this is strictly DI only. The other thing is the S68 does not have an electronic VANOS system. And I know I've seen a lot of articles saying that it does, but at this point, the engine is readily available. You can look up the details on any BMW parts site. And so if you look up the part numbers, you'll see that the cam gears are the exact same as the S63 part numbers. And if you look at the central valves and the VANOS actuators, those are the same ones that we've got even on a Gen 1 B58. So nothing really revolutionary or changed here related to the Vanos system. It's the same hydraulically controlled variable cam timing that we've been used to for a while. And the other thing that I think a lot of you will be excited to hear is it does not have the exhaust valve deactivation. So there's nothing set up in there that will prevent the exhaust valves from opening. There's no extra mechanisms in the valve train. It's just the typical BMW valve train with three cams and extra variable valve lift instead of throttle bodies, even though we still have throttle bodies just in case the variable valve lift doesn't work. You get the idea. It's basically what we're already used to. However, I think the biggest issue with this is the hybrid system. This is something that not only is taking away from probably some of the performance that we could experience with these cars, but also adding a ridiculous amount of weight. I like how some other, you know, higher performance manufacturers are integrating the hybrid technology where they have small motors, small batteries, and all that's used for is to add extra power. Versus in BMW's case, it's built into the transmission. The entire powertrain is basically redesigned just to take advantage of that hybrid setup. And so it's just not really favoring the engine, in my opinion, especially in the version of the M5. That was our best opportunity to really see what the S68 can do. And instead, with the batteries and everything else, it weighs over 1,000 pounds more than the previous M5. And the F90 was an amazing car to begin with. I would love to have an M5 competition, regardless of how much I would be paying for repairs and maintenance in the future. It's just a really solid car. And now that they've put the S68 in the new M5, I think it's really a lost opportunity. But that's a trend that we've seen from all automakers. Just look at the C63, because they all have to prepare for the new Euro emissions laws. Pretty much all of the German manufacturers are implementing hybrid technology across all of their vehicles. Now we've even got it on the new 911 and all of these cars. They're going to have some kind of hybrid technology so they can keep selling cars in Europe. So it is what it is, but personally, I think that's the biggest downside. It's really going to be a challenge to see what the S68 is capable of when it's only being put in literal tanks. But hopefully people that are buying these cars still get to enjoy the power and torque that's available. So yeah, overall, I think the S68 is definitely going in the right direction from a design standpoint. They're keeping things simple, reusing parts that we know that work, and improving things that could be made better. You'll hopefully see maybe that something will change where we'll get a performance version of the M5 or something that's a little bit lighter weight, maybe a slightly different implementation of the hybrid technology. Hopefully we get tunes available so we can turn up the boost, especially those of you that are getting the lower horsepower version. You easily have an extra 100+ horsepower on tap that is, you know, from BMW standpoint, perfectly reliable in other cars. So we'll just have to see what comes out over time. But let me know your thoughts, what else you've heard about the S68. If there's anything that I missed, definitely reach out and let me know and we can keep the conversation going. But I think that's it for this video. So thank you guys for watching and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below.